Hey, fellow fragrance lovers and enthusiasts, welcome back. It's Benjamin here at the Centaur Fragrance Channel, coming back at you, showcasing a whole new beautiful fragrance. Hopefully, I can help you find something that you love. That's what my channel is all about, exploring everything from cheapies, affordable fragrances, to niche and indie, and everything else out there since related. So today, I want to talk about a fragrance from the house of V. Canto. If you don't know about V. Canto, they're actually a side company to Tinzian Terenzi. Their fragrances are perhaps a little bit more affordable, and also are a little, sometimes take a departure a little bit from the traditional Italian style, but they certainly do feel Italian to me. So this one is called Amans. Let me show you this very pretty bottle. Presentation real quick. I know presentation is not everything, but this does have a little twist around this circle here. This keeps it tight and closed. For some people, you might cut the string or something. I think keeping the bottle is important, and especially with something that's niche. You know, we'll talk about the price later on and what you're getting into, but isn't that a beautiful presentation? I certainly think so. Let's talk about what we got going on here. V. Canto Amans. So this is an extract to parfum concentration, but before we get into all that, y'all know how we do it. We'll talk about the notes. This is an interesting juice. Let me spray it here. This, my friends, I'm not absolutely crazy about it. Let me tell you why. This is a citrus, more of a citrus vetiver fragrance to my nose, but what the notes are there's some rosemary, there's some nutmeg, and there's some cardamom. There's some fresh, you know, of course, those herbaceous nuances, and of course, almost some like earthy, spicy little nuances going on. But overall, it does feel mostly an aquatic or citrus aquatic, but there's definitely more going on. There's some notes of patchouli and some other notes. This fragrance is a little bit complex, but I don't get all the notes. What I get to my nose is, somewhat of a briny, not exactly a sea fragrance. You know, when I mean briny, if you've ever smelled a fresh oyster, there's like almost an iodine quality about it. And this is one of the first and only fragrances that I've smelled that almost has an iodine-like smell to it, which I actually find fascinating. And something contributing to that quality in the fragrance is certainly citronella. And that's really most likely what I don't like about this fragrance. Any fragrance that has citronella, it's something that I don't find particularly pleasant. It's a sort of green, sharp, almost to me synthetic smelling, even if it's natural, type of lemon. And to me, I just have a bad nostalgic or bad history with that fragrance. And in the South, you use that kind of stuff to avoid mosquitoes, and it reminds me of being bit by mosquitoes and burning those in in your tent and trying to keep yourself safe from insects here in the Wild South, which it's actually considered subtropical in some parts around here. But anyways, enough of my little rant, a little story. This fragrance is well done. It's well composed. It's an extract to parfum, very highly concentrated. It's not too expensive. It's 100 mils. It's a full-size bottle. And you can pick these up on sale for $100. Some of these actually are underrepresented. They're under-talked about. There's very few ladies. I mean, people just in general who have talked about it. But there is a lady, Tomalise, who has talked about these fragrances in a little bit more detail. I do need to try the rest of the brands and the rest of the fragrances. I should do it, but it might be a while until I get to them. I don't have any access to these fragrances, and I had to blind buy this one out of my own money. And even getting these on sale, they're usually around $100. Full retail, about $180. So is this, we'll talk about the performance again, and I'll give you all my final thoughts, everything wrapped up. What do I think about this fragrance with the performance and everything? This, I get just 6 or 7 hours, guys. I don't get amazing performance, and I really wish that I got six or, you know, I if I got 7 hours plus, I would like it a little bit more, but it is a citrus, so it's not bad performance. 6 or 7 hours, extrait to parfum. It gets me about average projection. It doesn't really leap off the skin. It's not beast mode. It's, even though it's an extrait, it's still a citrus, and, you know, citrus fragrances are what they are, unless you get something heavily synthetic. So this is decent as far as performance goes. And for the price, you know, some people pay, will pay even more for a citrus, a niche citrus, based on Francis Kurtjohn's, Aqua Universalis, for example. That one approaches $300 for a bottle. So some people really do like their citrus. So it really depends. It's up to you. Getting into that price and the compliment factor wise, it did get noticed. When it did, it often people thought it was nice and they thought it was an interesting take on something citrusy. But citrusy fragrances, I always feel, do get me more compliments. But this one was a little bit different, so it was a little bit less complimented than a really popular citrus or a blue fragrance. Honestly, blue fragrances are always big compliment getters. But what is also interesting about this fragrance is that because it's a little bit different, it also is kind of a nice sweet spot between being relatable and understandable. People understand citrus, people like citrus, and also being a little bit interesting. So it was a good conversation starter, but I never got any big attention, and I never got anything terribly, a seductive reaction, like, somebody was definitely, turned on because of the fragrance. I didn't get anything like that with this one, but it's a fine fragrance. It's Italian. It feels Italian. It's pretty well composed. It's a Tinzian Terenzi fragrance. Well done. I like the presentation. I do have to say that I do wish that I love this fragrance more. I am going to have to let this one go from my collection. I wish that it was something that I connected with. That citronella, just about any fragrance that has that doesn't work for me. I wish that, I like patchouli. It perhaps has a little bit of a nuances of perhaps that 80s, 90s vibe patchouli, but it's very subtle. It's in the background. And again, that all those other notes that got me initially interested in the fragrance, the nutmeg, the cardamom, the patchouli, mixed in with this very mass appealing Italian citrus kind of vibe, are very mute, very soft-spoken, and blended into the fragrance, making it, of course, more wearable, but also, to me, less interesting. I would rather have something deeper and richer and more complex with this fragrance. So, not a bad fragrance, not a bad creation. I am going to have to let this one go from my collection, though. All things considered, if you can find this fragrance for $100 or less, if you really like citrus fragrances, if you don't like things that are terribly daring or unique, which is fine. Citrus fragrances, a lot of people love them for good reason. This might be something that's a little bit step on the creative side, a little bit step on something that's a little bit different, and could be great for, people stepping out of blue fragrances or people who really, really like citrus. This could be something that you could find maybe a little bit higher class, a little bit higher quality. Again, I don't like citronella, but if you like things like Acqua di Parma's Essenza and those kinds of things, this doesn't smell the same. I'm not saying that, but you might like this if you like that style and family of fragrances. So anyways, guys, I'm not going to make this review too long. Thank y'all for spending your time with me, hanging out, learning about this fragrance. This is one of the very few reviews of this fragrance that's out there. And if you're wondering, I do, sometimes, collaborate with brands, but I paid this one full money and I actually blind bought it. That's one reason I'm a tiny bit disappointed. I often do well on my blind buys. Had high expectations, but y'all know that we all get terribly picky after we've smelled hundreds and hundreds of fragrances. So I'll see y'all, everybody. Enjoy your fragrances, wear what you love, rock what you got. This is a fine fragrance. I don't know if I'll get back to giving things a score, but if I was to give this a score, I'd probably, for me personally, give it like a 6. And probably an overall score, probably a 7 for me personally, or maybe a 7.5, but it's not bad. Anyways, guys, have a beautiful day. Stay well, stay safe, and smell beautiful. Y'all know what it's all about. And I'll see you next time, everybody. Peace out, and bye.